Hoy tangles are really cool when you mean for them to happen, but a lot less cool when you don't. And as we start off learning to spin poi, tangles are kind of inevitable, especially with wall plane moves. So how do we get past them and into a place where we can flow more freely? Drex here from Drex Factor Poi, sharing with you the love of poi spinning and flow arts to benefit your body and brain. And in this video, I'll show you how you can avoid those pesky tangles once you start working in wall plane. Before we dive in, I just want to give a quick shout out to the friends of the channel. Big thanks to Dark Monk, Flow DNA, Flow Fests, Flow Toys, Juggling Calling, Pyroterra Light Toys, Spin Balls, and Ultra Poi for helping to make the videos on this channel possible. You can learn more about all these amazing companies and the work that they're doing to support flow artists like yourself by checking out the links that I've got down in the description of this video. If I were to make a guess, most of us out there started off our poi journey with a trick that works in wheel plane, such as reels or weaves. And that's not a coincidence. Why? It's because when we spin our poi on our sides, we're less likely to tangle them up with each other. If the tethers never cross, they can never get all knotted up. But that also means that when we do switch over to wall plane tricks like butterflies and tuck turns, we might find that our poi are now prone to running into each other or tangling, specifically because we're unused to working in wall plane. And today, I'm going to show you the two most common strategies for avoiding tangles in wall plane. Whether you spin for 3 months or 3 decades, I can guarantee you're going to need at least one of them. So let's dive in. First up, a little bit of a review. I'm going to be using terms associated with timing and direction a lot in this video, specifically the 4 modes of timing and direction. For a full description of what timing and direction is, as well as how we get these 4 basic modes, check out the links in the description. For now, you only need to know that there are 4 modes, and this is what they all look like. Together time, same direction. Together time, opposite direction. Split time, same direction. And split time, opposite direction. Now, no matter what you do with poi, you'll almost certainly be using one or more of these modes with your poi, your hands, or both. And crucially, if you can figure out how to spin your poi in wall plane in any of these modes, that also means that you've acquired the knowledge to fix tangles for any poi trick that works in those modes. You'll also note, I'm performing all of these modes in wall plane to show you that it is possible to do so. But it's going to take a little bit of work for us to make it happen. Our first technique for ironing out tangles is something I refer to as plane tilt. And if you've seen my videos on performing butterflies, you're probably already familiar with it. Whenever we perform butterflies in together same, it's common for us to tilt the plane of the top poi back towards ourselves while we point the top of the bottom poi plane away from ourselves, essentially creating an X between the planes when viewed from the side. But our audience has no idea that the planes aren't perfectly parallel. To them, it looks simply like the two poi are swinging past each other without colliding, almost magically. And as it turns out, this is also a tool that we can use to avoid tangles in other timing and direction modes as well. For instance, in split time opposites, from the front, it once again looks like the poi would normally collide at either side of the pattern. But tilting the top poi plane backwards wouldn't do much to fix this because the poi would come in contact with each other right in the middle of that X from the together same example. So how do we fix this one? We still tilt the poi planes, but rather than creating an X when viewed from the side, we instead create an X when viewed from above. This means that when we're on the right side, the right poi plane is tilted slightly back, and when we're on the left side, the left poi plane is tilted slightly back. Same concept, but the planes are tilted from a different perspective. To understand why this works, we have to understand where the poi are going to collide and where they're going to come apart. In together opposite, the poi come together at the top and bottom and are apart on either side. This means that we want to tilt our poi planes such that the poi are separate on the top and bottom. In split time opposite, the poi come together at either side of the pattern, but are separate top and bottom. So we want to tilt the planes to separate the poi planes to either side. Make sense? These techniques are super important no matter how complex the poi trick is. For example, here I'm performing a pendulum versus cap anti-brid, a poi hybrid in which the poi spin in opposites and come together at either side. See how I'm tilting the planes of each poi to avoid tangles and collisions here? You can actually practice this technique by exaggerating how bowed out the planes are when you're performing them. For example, you can flatten down your planes in butterfly to a point where they're almost horizontal and then straighten them back up to vertical. This will give you more control over plane orientation and, especially when starting out, allow you to orient your planes in such a way that you can avoid those tangles more easily. This also works in split time opposite. Bow out the planes to either side and then work to straighten them back out again. This will help you work through the range of motion you have here so you can find your optimum angle of tilt. Okay, so what about together same? In that case, the poi are sticking together top and bottom as well as on either side. So do we tilt the planes side to side or top and bottom to avoid collisions? Actually, both. If you look at someone spinning their poi in together same from the side or the top, you'll see the exact same X shape that we'd expect from the two opposite modes, but you'll see it both going from side to side as well as top and bottom. Basically, together same involves taking the lessons from both together opposite and split time opposite and making them work together at the same time. And despite all of that, the trick still looks perfectly normal from the audience's perspective. You'd be surprised how much plane tilt you can get away with and the audience still has no idea. Don't think of the straightness of your planes as being sacrosanct. You have some wiggle room and you shouldn't be afraid to explore it. So, the obvious question. Does this technique work for split time same direction, wherein the poi are separated at all times? No. Actually, it does not. To perform split time same direction in wall plane without the poi tangling, we have to employ a different technique, one that actually works for all the other modes as well. This is a technique I like to refer to as plane lanes or poi lanes. Here's how it works. First up, you're going to need to separate your hands out a poi's length apart. You can get away with slightly shorter distances once you get good at this technique, but for right now, start here. Next, you'll position one hand slightly further forward than the other, say just a couple inches. Now you should be able to spin your poi in split time same direction in wall plane without getting in any tangles or collisions. And again, from the audience's perspective, it just seems like the poi are spinning past each other. It doesn't present as though we've quite literally displaced them in different lanes of depth. And we can apply this same technique to literally all the timing and direction modes too. This works in together same, as well as together opposite, as well as split time opposite. This is also a tool that's super useful for positions in which the hands are on a vertical rather than horizontal line, or out to the sides too. You rarely see the hands together in the center when the people perform split time same direction in wall plane, but it gets more common when the hands are out to the side because there's more room for the rear poi to spin between the arms. Depending upon the trick, where it's positioned around the body, and of course, how close together the hands need to be in order to perform it, you might find yourself using either or both of these techniques at the same time. Be sure to practice them both to get a feel for how you can get the most out of wall plane for whatever tricks you're interested in learning. Did you get anything out of this video? Please make sure to like, comment, share, and subscribe to help other people find it, as well as to help my channel grow. I also just wanted to put out a huge thank you because this video would not be possible without the kind contributions of these wonderful folks right here. These are my Flow patrons on Patreon, and they, along with the wonderful people listed down in the description, helped to make this video and all the videos on my channel possible. If you'd like to help me out in my mission to bring poi spinning and flow arts to the wider world and help people learn to be creative with their brains and their bodies, you can do so by heading on over to patreon.com/drexfactorpoi and signing up. There you can get early access to all of my content, a say in what topics I tackle in the future, plus some great extras and behind the scenes content as well. So go check that out. Please and thank you. What challenges are you running into with your poi spinning, and how can I help? Leave me a comment and let me know, and I might make a video on the specific challenge that you're facing. In the meantime, I'll leave a link to a playlist on some other beginner poi lessons that I've done down in the description, as well as up on screen if you're watching on YouTube. Be sure to get outside and flow today, and I'll see you with a brand new video on Friday. Peace.